Hello, in this video I want to show you how you can analyze flow operations on a MongoDB database system by using the MongoDB flow operations profiler tool, which has been open sourced on GitHub, as you can see here. Here you are seeing the application status page. Below is a table where all the registered databases are shown. Each line represents one database running on a MongoD. Here you are seeing only four lines because I put a filter on it, because I put in the search box the part of the name backend because I'm interested in seeing only the offer list service backend database. So only four lines are shown from a total of 479. When you want to analyze these flow operations, just verify that you have profiling turned on already. And this is the threshold of 100 milliseconds in this case. The threshold of 100 milliseconds means that all operations taking longer than 100 milliseconds are being profiled. And verify also that collecting is on, which is the case here, which means that all these profiled operations are being collected into the database, which is used to analyze these slow operations later on. If you want to enable profiling and collecting, you just select the lines, click on profile, put in the threshold, 100 milliseconds for example, and click start for turning on the profiling or stop to turn it off. And the same goes for collecting, start or stop. In this case, this has been set up already. So we have collected, we have profiled and then collected some slow operations, so we are able to analyze it, and we just analyze these columns and click on the Analyze button, which will open up the Analyze page. And I scroll down to the table, which I want to show you because I think this table is very great to analyze flow operations very quickly. However, this table is quite huge because it has many columns, so I suggest you to click on the clean link here, which will hide some of these columns. As you can see here, some of these columns are now grayed out. You can click on it to show them again, but here I want to get rid of them, so I leave them hidden. If you want to see the slowest query first, just sort by max and S and us in descending order, and you see here the slowest query took 237 seconds, which is very slow. This is because no index was used, as you can see here in the column R keys. R keys means how many keys were read from the index. In this case, 0, which indicates no index at all was used. However, in the column R docs, which means read docs, means how many docs were read from the disk, you can see that 5 million docs were read from the disk. However, only 100 of these 5 million documents were returned to the client. So you see here in the column sum read, only 100 were returned, which leads to this very huge number of 2,544 milliseconds per returned document, which is very bad. So this query is very bad, but in the same time I don't think that this query was responsible for slowing down the whole database system, because only two times this query has been executed. So let's see what was the most expensive operation by clicking on the SumMS column in descending order. We see here the most expensive operation took 25,000 seconds, and it queried two fields. The first field with a dollar in operator. If you can't really interpret this syntax, just click the example link, which shows you an example of the slow operation document, so means the query. In this case, you see here the query filter, underscore ID list identifier with the dollar in operator with only one value, but you could have a lot of values in this array. And another field where was queried underscore id dot side id with an equality operation with value 2. So this makes easy to understand which query has been executed. For example, the last line I see also underscore id has been queried, but with a whole object. So underscore id, as you saw here already, is a composed field. It contains more fields than just a value. It contains a document. And here you see the whole document of the id has been queried. If I click the example, you see here the id is composed of these three fields, and all these three fields were queried. So just to remind you that you can click the example link if you can't really interpret this syntax. Yeah, let's continue to analyze. The second slow operation was a get more operation. And you see the same fields were queried than the first operation type, which was a query. So this means the first operation, the query, which were executed 68,000 times, involved a get more operation of more than 17,000 times. So the client didn't want the first batch of each query, he requested more batches. This is why we can see here many get more operations followed by this operation. And in the column max bytes, you can see how many bytes per request were transferred back to the client. In this case, 16 megabytes, which corresponds to the maximum size of a JSON document. So this means that the request requested many data. So this slows down, of course, also the query, because it has to transfer many data back to the client. In this third line, it's very interesting to see that the same fields as above were queried, but by a remove operation. So it seems that the client first identified all the documents and then removed some of them. Only some of them, because I see here in the column wdocs, which means how many docs were written, that 3 million docs were written. Since it's a remove operation, it means 3 million documents were removed. But as we saw earlier, the client requested in total 15 million documents to be returned and deleted 3 million. So perhaps it can be optimized, I don't know, but you got the idea how to interpret these numbers. I want to show you also on the application status page how you can easily verify how many times the indexes were accessed. You do this by selecting the databases you are interested in. In this case, I'm just interested to see the index access stats of the primary. And I want to issue the command against the MongoDB instance, not against the router, because I want not to query the secondaries, just the primaries. And I issue the index access stats command. And then I sort by the column number of accesses in ascending order. And then I see the first four lines are zero, means these indexes never has been accessed. This is not a good sign. Maybe these collections have never been used, because their primary key, the underscore ID field, which is indexed, has never been accessed. Also, as you can see here in the offer key index, there are indexes which have been rarely accessed, only 49 times in this case. So perhaps it's a waste of resources to have an index which is not frequently accessed. Just check if you can drop those indexes. Perhaps they were used in the past but not used anymore, so these are candidates to drop as well. In the same manner, you could see the collection stats. Just issue the command collection stats, for example, in order to see if your indexes are small enough to fit still in RAM. Just sort by the column total index size in descending order. And so you see the biggest indexes first, and you can evaluate if your index is small enough to fit still in RAM. And you see also of this collection all the indexes here. Yeah, also you have here a search box, so you can easily filter out an index you're interested in to see. I don't know, for example, no, site, shop ID, for example, shop ID. Here you have all indexes where shop ID is in an index. So this was the first insight of the slow operations profile. I hope you gained some insights and are able to analyze your slow queries by your own. Bye bye.